Hello everyone, I'm Shivangi Tiwari from Hidayatullah National Law University. Today in this video, I'm going to talk about the lapse of offer. So firstly, I'm going to tell you the topics which I'm going to cover under this video. So firstly, I'll be talking about proposal or offer. Secondly, the notice of revocation. Third will be communication of revocation of the offer. Fourth will be lapse of time. And fifth is failure to accept a condition precedent in an offer. So firstly, I'm going to talk about the meaning of offer or proposal. So according to the Indian Contract Act 1872, a proposal is defined under section 2A of the Act. So according to this section, when one person signifies to another person his willingness to do or not to do something with a view to obtain the assent of such person to such an act or abstinence is said to make a proposal or offer. So there are three ways of termination of offer, and the three of them are firstly revocation of offer, secondly rejection, and third is lapse of time. So firstly, I'm going to talk about the revocation of an offer. So the dictionary meaning of revocation is annulling any work which was previously done. In the law of contracts, a contract is entered into between two or more parties when one party makes an offer to another with a view of obtaining the assent of the other party to the offer. And once the offer of the person is accepted, a valid contract is entered into between the parties. However, the parties to the contract are at liberty to revoke both offer and acceptance at a later point of time. So now we are going to talk about the notice of revocation. So section 5 of the Indian Contract Act provides that any proposal can be revoked by the offeree at any time before the communication of acceptance is complete as against the offerer and not afterwards. So the communication of acceptance is said to be completed as against the offerer or the proposer when the acceptance is put in the course of transmission to him so as to be out of control of the offeree. Therefore, in case of communication of acceptance by electronic mail, the communication of offer is said to be complete when it reaches the offeree before he mails the acceptance, thus making it out of his control. It is important that revocation, in order to be effective, should be brought into notice of the person to whom it is made. There is also an important question that arises in this context, that what happens in the cases of withdrawal of offer is made by the offerer before the expiry of fixed period. Because in certain cases, the offerer prescribes a certain time limit within which the offeree has to accept the offer in order to enter into a valid contract. So in these cases, the offerer has the authority to withdraw the offer even before the expiry of the prescribed time period, and also there is an important ruling, Madras High Court ruling in this context, that which was of Alfred Skolenk and another versus Muthiana Chetty. So now we are going to discuss about the acceptance of proposal under the voluntary retirement scheme or the VRS. So under this scheme, the employees were given the right to apply for voluntary retirement by requesting the same in writing to the authorities. However, the authorities in these cases had complete discretion to accept or reject the requests of these employees. The requirement of the employee who requested under the scheme could take place only once the request has been accepted by the authorities in writing. The scheme was only an invitation to an offer, and the application was made by the employee was just an offer to the authorities who were there for the offeree. The employee, being the offerer, could withdraw the offer at any time before his offer is accepted by the offeree. The term of the scheme preventing the employee from the withdrawal of the proposal was held to be non-binding in the case of K. Appa Rao versus Messrs. Tungabhadra Steel Products Limited. So, and then there's communication of revocation of offer. So this this part is dealt with under Section 6(1) of the Indian Contract Act, which mandates that the revocation could be made only by the offeror and no other person. So revocation of general offer is the next topic that we are going to deal with. So in the case where the offer of general nature is made known to the public at large through any media, the withdrawal of the offer should be conveyed through the same media through which it was made. So the revocation should be made, would be effective even where any person in ignorance of the revocation subsequently performs the term of the offer which has already been withdrawn. Now we are going to talk about the superseding proposal by a fresh proposal. So in a case where proposal is renewed, not in entirety, but some part of it is renewed before the acceptance is made to the original offer and the letter appears to supersede the proposal, then such a proposal will no longer be available for acceptance for the offeree. The acceptance could only be of the renewed part which has superseded the earlier or original proposal. Now there's a question on revocation of bid. So how is revocation of bids made? So in a case where an agreement is entered into by auction, the acceptance to the agreement is signified by knocking down of the hammer thrice by the auctioneer. So a bid can be withdrawn before the hammer is actually knocked down by the seller, because the knocking down of the hammer signifies the acceptance of the auctioneer. And now there's another way of termination of offer that we'll be discussing about, which will be a lapse of time. So where in a contract a fixed time has been prescribed to the offeree to communicate the acceptance, the offeree is bound to accept the offer within that fixed time which is so prescribed by the offerer, because after the expiry of the fixed time the offer lapses automatically. With regard to this facet of the contract law, the Calcutta High Court has suggested that in a case where the offeree has to communicate his acceptance within a specified time frame which is prescribed by the offerer, and he posts his acceptance within the stipulated time period, a binding contract shall be said to have arose between the two parties. The validity of the offer by the offeree would not be affected if the letter of acceptance so posted within the stipulated time which was prescribed by the offerer reaches the offerer after the completion of that specified time, because the offeree has already posted his acceptance within that time frame. So the last topic of our discussion will be by failure of revocation or termination of the offer by failure to accept a condition precedent. So where the offer is subject to the conditions precedent, that is some preconditions have to be complied with before the acceptance is made. If the acceptance is made by the offeree without the fulfillment of those conditions, then the offer lapses then and there. And a case in this regard would be State of West Bengal versus Mahindra Chandra Das. So in this case, what happened was a salt lake was offered by way of a lease with a condition that mentioned that the person accepting the lease has to deposit a certain sum of money within a specified time period. So the defendant in this case, who was the intended lessee, did not deposit the amount of the money which was specified even after the expiration of the time which was stipulated under the contract of lease. So what happened, in this case the court held that the conduct of the defendant clearly indicated that the allotment stood cancelled. So basically there was no valid or binding contract between the two parties which arose because of the failure on the part of the defendant to accept the condition which was prescribed by the offerer. So that was all for today's video. I hope that you find this video helpful. Thank you.